Assalamu alaikum to all the students of 401. Okay, today we are going to start a new topic, that is matrices, as you can see on your slide photo. But this is basically not included in your D3 and D4 course. Okay, it is the part of your Cambridge upgraded syllabus that is given on the internet as well. You can check it from the website. The 42 topics that we have to discuss about mathematics, this topic is included matrices, but it's not briefed in the D4, D3 because they are the latest version. I hope in the upcoming version they will include this topic. But we're going to start this topic right now because this is one of the very crucial stuff. And even in the past paper, you can see a lot of questions regarding this. Okay, so let us start with what is basically a matrix. A matrix is basically a rectangular array of numbers or letters enclosed in a square bracket. This is the basic definition and theme. Okay, what is the elaboration there? You can see that I have written some letters or numbers, minus 5, 2, 4. What are these? These are numbers by definition. And what about this small a that is enclosed in the bracket? This is basically a letter. So when I enclose these numbers or letters in a square bracket, as I have written there, this becomes a matrix. Okay, what are these properties? Why we use matrices? We will, once we move forward, we will discuss them all. Now, please understand one or two basic ideas. I won't want to write these things, very basic stuff, but you have to remember them. Matrix is always denoted by a capital letter. For example, what is the name of this matrix? A. This A should be capital. No matrix can be named with a small letter. I hope it's clear. Very simple concept. And similarly, if you have to write something inside a matrix, and this is an English letter, this should be a small letter. A capital A cannot be enclosed in a matrix. For example, I have written there a rectangular array of numbers or letters. So letter within a matrix will always be a small letter. And the name of the matrix is always going to be a letter always, never a number. The name of the matrix is always going to be represented by a capital letter. Okay. Now let us move towards some basic theme line of this particular topic. Row and column. The definition simply defines us that, okay, one more thing, this particular one stuff, for example, I have circled this A. This A will be called an element or an entry of a matrix. You can write these two things, element or entry. Both are valid. What about this minus 5? This minus 5 is also, an element or entry of a matrix. Similarly, this 2 and 4. So I would say this matrix has 4 elements or 4 entries. Now move towards this one, row. Horizontal chain of elements. What is mean by horizontal? You already know through graphical explanation, left to right stuff. So this combination, minus 5 and 2, this will be the first row. A4, this will be the second row. Okay, so horizontal division of a particular matrix of all elements will make it a row. Similarly, a vertical chain of elements, top to bottom, you will see that this will become a column. For example, minus 5 and A is a column number 1, and 2 and 4 is a column number 2. Now this is a very important definition, order. For a matrix having m number of columns and n number of rows, order is m cross n. What it means? I have given an example there. This is a matrix B. How many rows it have? Guess it yourself. You have to divide this matrix in left to right stuff. This is the first row, this is the second row, and this is the third row. Okay, so there are 3 rows. And how many columns are there? 2 columns, 1 and 2. Okay, so the order will be 3 cross 2. Rows will always be written first. I have written there that M is a number of rows, then M is always first. Okay, so this is the number of rows into column becomes a order. Now, this is a very genuine question that comes in the mind. What does order gives us? For example, I tell you a matrix of order 3 by 2. What it actually means? What is the answer of this 3 by 2? That is 6. So basically it's showing that this matrix has 6 elements. Okay, you can count them all. Is it become 6? Total number of elements are 6. And similarly, this also shows that this matrix has 3 rows and 2 columns. I will draw your matrix that has 2 rows and 3 columns. This will also have an order, the number of elements 6. But this will be a different matrix from this one because it has 2 rows and 3 columns. So it all depends on the properties regarding a matrix and it defines all things. Okay, so that is the basic theme of order. Now the next property, the second one, transpose. A matrix obtained by interchanging rows and columns with each other is called transpose. Very crucial definition. What is actually mean by this? For example, you have a matrix this A. First of all, tell me how many rows and columns it have. Basic stuff. It has 2 rows. Okay, and how many columns it has? If you are guessing it's 3, you are right. It has three columns, okay? Two rows and three columns. Okay. Now for transpose. Transpose is denoted by T in the power. Just like you write A square, you have to write A transpose. And this transpose will be in the power, but it is just representing that we have taken the transpose of the previous matrix. Okay, what to do for the transpose now? There are two possibilities. You can go either way. Either read the matrix in a row and write the matrix in column. I will repeat my words. Read the matrix in row, write the matrix in column. For example, you have read the first row, 2, 5, 4. This is the first row. Okay. You have written 2, 5, 4 in column. Okay. Read it in row, 2, 5, 4 and write it in column. Similarly, read the second row, 3, 1, 0 and write it in column 3, 1, 0. This is the transpose of a matrix. Got that? There is another way as well. You can read in column and write in row. It's very similar. For example, first row is 2, 3. Second column is 5, 1. Second row is 5, 1. And similarly, the last one. It's up to you now how you're going to manage. But you have to do it only one way. Do not mix both things in a similar step. Either read in row, write in column, or either write in row or read in a column. Okay? So that is the basic theme of a transpose. Now coming to the last definition, this is a very simple stuff. A matrix obtained by changing the signs of all elements. What is element? I have already discussed above that every particular entry is called element. Every entry is an element. Okay, so the matrix that is obtained by changing the sign of all elements. Remember, I'm using the word all elements. And you have to change the sign. Do not consider it by definition that you have to put a negative on all elements. That's not right. You have to change the sign. For example, I've given an example. This is a C matrix. It has four elements, and what is its order, by the way? It's 2 by 2, okay? Two number of rows and two number of columns. And I will remind you people that you have to write number of rows first and then number of columns. Okay, so coming up to the basic property of this matrix, that is this one. Negative C will be equal to this matrix. How? This was minus 4, so this is 4. This was 2 by 3, it's minus 2 by 3. Zero never alters its sign. Very genuine reality. And 7 will become minus 7. So these are the three basic things that we have discussed in this topic. What is a matrix? Rows and column. Left to right is row and top to bottom is column. The first property is order. Number of rows into number of columns is what we call order. Similarly, if you change the rows and column with each other, okay, this will become transpose and changing all the signs becomes negative of what matrix. Now, these are the five questions assigned to you people. You have to write the order of all these five matrix. You have to write the transpose of all these five matrix, and you have to write the negative of all these matrix. It's very comfortable, I would say. So this is the basic intro of matrices. Inshallah, we will come to the higher level in the next coming lectures. Thank you very much.